Hi folks, so this is David Kwan here, and I'm continuing to still seriously talk about Watch Dogs. I hope that, you know, a lot of people have talked about this game already, and I'm very late to the party. There have been tons of reviews, tons of opinions on these things, but the things that I talk about about this game regarding how Aiden Pierce is a sociopath, the kind of the ethical dilemmas that I face when using the profiler algorithm that Aiden Pierce has developed, I hope these are not, you know, I hope these are kind of things that are fresh to you guys as you've been around the scene in the gaming industry, gaming press scene. Because I really haven't really read much or seen much about talking about that kind of stuff. Now, this video, the things that I'm going to talk about Watch Dogs, is pretty, you know, it's commonly talked about. So not really adding too much new to this discussion. But I did find really interesting, you know, the kind of the level design in which I used Aiden's hacking abilities, used the phone to hack into a surveillance camera, and then now I'm watching through the lens of the surveillance camera, and then I try to find another surveillance camera, another phone, and I go into that. The whole level in which I have to guide, what is his name? He's kind of forget his name. Bedbug, right. So his nickname is Bedbug, or his call name is Bedbug, and he goes into this projects facility, into housing projects, and you have to guide through him because the housing projects is pretty much secured and operated by Iraq. That's also another person's name. This person who has a nickname Iraq, he's the leader of this kind of very underground criminal organization that is being funded by one of the business philanthropists of the entire, pretty much he's an insidious influencer in the city of Chicago in Watch Dogs, with very close connection with the mayor of Chicago himself. And I found it really interesting the income. You know, you can use a profiler to check how much money he makes, and that's really interesting. I think it's something around like 1 million. I don't quite remember. But that level was really kind of intriguing. You just kind of go through that level, guiding Bedbug. The entire level, you're just trying to find surveillance cameras, finding areas to do. So I thought that was pretty neat, although it's kind of disorienting a little bit because it's just like, and it's also kind of like far-fetched that every camera that you kind of are able to access remotely by hacking, you can also find another phone or camera to guide Bedbug to his destination. So pretty far-fetched, but it was actually really, really unique, really fun. I enjoyed that a lot. That I think that level is one of the like the most memorable thing that kind of stands out. And then you have to visit that housing project's facility again, but it's more of like, it's a typical take cover, shoot, and kill a whole bunch of people along the way, and then finally confront Iraq. The conversation that you have with Iraq, I thought was a little bit interesting, although like the influence that he, so, you know, I thought that was pretty cool. Oh, also another thing that I want to mention about kind of the combat mechanics of Watch Dogs is a majority of the time actually tried not to use guns, but actually take them down stealthily. And it's an open world game that I actually think did stealth in a pretty good way. It doesn't limit the enemy's vision that much, which is one way to do it. But it doesn't utilize a mechanic of Aiden Pierce like hiding in the darkness, shadows, where nobody can see him, which is the mechanic that Splinter Cell's games use. Didn't really do that. It just felt very much more organic. Like, you're hidden from view, and you go to the enemy, you knock them out, and you hide from view, use surveillance cameras to kind of figure out your surrounding, use the third-person camera, and you go there, and you could knock them out. And there are many tools to kind of utilize to knock them out. I wish there were more non-lethal methods, rather than the lethal methods that happen, but you can upgrade your skill tree around that. There are stun weapons that you can kind of develop. I think There's just one other stun gadget that you can develop, which I used quite frequently. Although something I learned later, way later in the game, I wish I had known this sooner. There are non-lethal methods, there are non-lethal takedowns that you can do with using your guns. So I learned this when I was reading through a game fact about Watch Dogs, but if you shoot them in the head or if you shoot them in the torso, of course, you're going to kill them. But if your final shot is like in the limbs, in the arms, or the legs, you'll actually incapacitate the enemy, and that doesn't kill him. So I thought that would have been very helpful to know in some of the missions where the mission is to incapacitate the enemy. And I was just trying to always take him down physically by going up there and pressing the circle button. But you can actually do non-lethal takedowns using firearms. Of course, don't use explosives because that will kill them outright. At a later part of the game, you know, I have so much. I bought everything. I bought all the clothes. I bought all the weapons. And it becomes a lot easier. The driving contracts, you just park somewhere, wait for the car to come in, and just blow them out of the water with the grenade launcher. Boom. Mission complete. But so far, I think that's really all I have to say about Watch Dogs so far. I mean, there's still probably a lot more I want to say. But overall, I think it's a, you know, those are the things that really made me think the most or feel the most with Aiden Pierce and the portrayal of that character and his interactions with the other characters in the game. Which I wasn't really invested in the story, overarching plot itself, but I was really actually invested in this character, Aiden Pierce, and how uncomfortable I felt controlling him, which is another thing. And the profiler itself, and a lot of the mechanics in this game, design of this game, I really, really, really liked. So overall, like, I think I'm glad that I had the experience of Watch Dogs. I know why it just didn't win any Game of the Year awards or anything like that. I think that makes sense. It's not a game. I think there was a huge hype for this game, but it did not meet those hype expectations this game. So it makes sense to me. But that's what I have to say. Tell me guys what you think in the comment section below, and whatever that you guys do. Thanks for watching, guys. Cheers.